Welcome to our channel EduseX. Let us see some of the key points for writing a scientific manuscript. Now you have completed a research work and eager to make it public for the world to know about your research findings. You are the author and therefore it becomes your responsibility to make others understand what is your research all about. So you have to convey your research findings in a clear and concise way to the readers. So the key points to be addressed are what you did, what it means, and why it is important. First thing is to choose a journal which has topics related to your research work. Once the journal is decided, go through the instructions for authors carefully. Once you have fixed the journal for communicating your research work, then start arranging the sections of the manuscript as per journal guidelines. If the journal has any manuscript template, then it will be helpful for you. Arrange the sections and formatting as per the guidelines of the journal. Otherwise, the research article will bounce back from the journal before going to the editor of the journal. Another option to prepare a manuscript for a particular journal is to download a recently published research article of the journal and see the sections and formatting. Once you have decided the journal and well-versed with the guidelines of the journal, you can now prepare your manuscript as per the guidelines of the journal. Most of the journals will have the following sections: title of the research paper, author's list with affiliation and contact details, abstract, introduction, methods, results, conclusions and references. Your manuscript must clearly convey your research to the readers. Remember, your research paper, if published, will be read by researchers not only who are working in your area of research, but also by others. It is not a novel read for pleasure. It contains scientific information. So try to present your findings in a concise and direct way. Do not use complex sentences which are never ending. This will not deliver anything to the reader. Instead, make the reader confused, and it is a mere wastage of time. Remember, your manuscript is read first by the journal editor and then by the reviewers. So confusing with complex sentences should be avoided. Try to use simple, short and understandable sentences. The second important thing to be in your mind is to be consistent. Always use same type of abbreviations, nomenclature in the text, figures and tables throughout the manuscript. For example, in the first para, if you say nanocomposites to describe your material, then in entire manuscript you must use nanocomposites. It should not be nanomaterials in one place and nanocomposites in another place to describe the same material. This will confuse the reader. If you feel that using same type of words throughout creates a monotony, then it can be replaced with synonyms. But be careful, these synonyms must be universally understood. If there is a long version of a name, then you can write it in full in the first usage with abbreviation in parentheses. And later in the manuscript, you can use the abbreviations only. For example, powder X-ray diffraction can be abbreviated as PXRD. And later in the manuscript, it is enough if you use PXRD. If the abbreviations used are universally accepted, there is no problem in using them in your manuscript. For example, COVID-19, RNA, DNA, like that. If too many abbreviations are coming in your manuscript, then provide an abbreviations used section in your manuscript. Scientific writing must be in third person without any personal pronouns. For example, prepared samples were tested using SEM is correct, whereas we tested the samples using SEM is not correct. Results and methods are typically written in past tense. This is because you are reporting the procedure adapted for your experiment. Results obtained are already finished before you start writing the manuscript. In the introduction, you can mix present and past tenses depending upon the usage. If you are referring to a concept or a fact or a well-established process which is well known, then you can use present tense. You can also use personal pronouns. For example, silica reacts with carbon to give silicon. This is universal. On the other hand, if you are referring to a previous finding, especially in literature review, you have to use past tense. For example, Ravi et al. Showed that, or they confirmed that. Similarly, in conclusion part, past tense is used. Abstract must be clear and concise, not exceeding 250 words. Highlight the important points of your work and fit them correctly. The audience, on reading your abstract, must get a gist of your research findings and the conclusions derived. It is advisable to repeat the same words used in the introduction, results and conclusion for key concepts, assumptions, findings, etc. throughout your manuscript. In order to avoid repetitions, if you change words, then it may confuse the reader. This is because, except you, no one knows the topic. If someone is reading your article for the first time, and if you are using different words for the key concepts, findings in different sections of the article, then the reader will not understand what is your research all about. If this happens during review, then there is a chance for rejection of your manuscript. If that happens after publication, then it will affect the citation of your research. Both ways, you are the loser. Hope you have got an idea for writing a scientific manuscript. Let us see section-wise in the next video. Thank you for watching. Please comment, share, and subscribe.